Hi, this is Roger Hall, and this is Roger's Two Cents. I have in front of me a question given to me by somebody who attended one of my seminars. I don't know what it is, and I'll let you know what I think. I'll give you my two cents. How do you find and fulfill your life's purpose? I think there are frankly three ways to find and fulfill your life purpose. Most of us want to have that moment in time, life purpose. You know, we want to be like Churchill. After the war, a reporter came up to Churchill and said, "Tell me about your experience." And he says, "I feel like everything in my life led me to this moment." Every one of us wants to see the fulfillment of the purpose of our life. We want to have some sort of plant the flag dynamic change in the world, and we want to be able to see the effect of our work. So that's that sort of dramatic purpose, that we get to see the fruit of our life, and that we can, when we die, we can say, "Look, I fulfilled my purpose." But unfortunately, it's not always like that. I mean, we'd all like that, but it's not always like that. Sometimes it's that you do your daily discipline of your work, and the product of your work fulfills the purpose, but you may never see it happen, and that's frustrating. So if we look at Vincent van Gogh, what a lot of people are familiar with his paintings that now sell for millions, but what most people don't know is that he never sold a painting in his life. His brother would buy the, say, "Oh, Vincent, yeah, I've got people to buy your paintings," and would buy them from his brother and say that he was selling them in town, but he put them in a closet. And so Van Gogh kept at his art, he kept at his discipline, and never saw the fruit of his work. He thought there were some local people buying his paintings. Now our lives are enriched. Van Gogh's purpose was never fulfilled in his life. He had a very tragic life, but his stepwise progress of paint, 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 paint his whole life has fulfilled his purpose, but he never got to see it. And the third is an obscure purpose. And nobody wants this, but this is how life sometimes goes. So about 2,500 years ago, an Egyptian king decided he was going to do taxes, and he needed to raise tax money. So he had all these people carve stone inscriptions of the new tax notice. And because it was a multilingual society, the stone carver hammered it in hieroglyphics, hammered it in Sumerian, and hammered it in Greek. They post the sign, the taxes go through. At the end of that, what do they do with the sign? They throw it in the ash heap. They actually throw it and use it as building material. And they use it inside a wall to build this wall. About 1,000 years later, Napoleon is in Egypt and he's fighting a war and they need building material. So he sends, you know, the generals and the colonels and the majors send sergeants and privates out to scavenge from these buildings, building material for a road or whatever they were building. And so they're tearing down this building and somebody finds this broken stone and they look at it and they hand it to the corporal, or, you know, not a high ranking person. And he looks at it and he goes, "That's pretty interesting." So he sends it up the chain and it eventually ends up in the British Museum. And the stone that the stone carver made as a tax notice 2,500 years ago, thrown inside a wall that nobody knew about, picked up by some soldiers who didn't really know what it was, gets to the British Museum. Turns out this is the Rosetta Stone. Everything we know about hieroglyphics, it was indecipherable. No one knew what any of those hieroglyphics meant until they found the stone that has hieroglyphics, Sumerian, and Greek, and they could then translate. And from that, they built the understanding of what hieroglyphics mean. Now we can read hieroglyphics pretty well because some stone carver 2,500 years ago wrote a tax notice. Some soldier thought, "That's a pretty cool stone. Well, I wonder what that means." Neither of those men ever saw the purpose of their life. They were, the Egyptian stone carver was long dead, and the French soldier died before it was discovered what it all meant. So neither of them saw the purpose of their life, but their purpose was obscured. But everybody's life has a purpose. We may not get to see it, but it's still there. Yeah, we all want to be like Churchill, that everything in our life goes to change the course of history. But some of us, we just do our daily discipline and we have a purpose. And maybe it's not like Van Gogh. Maybe our purpose is to build in the lives of our children or into our community. And other people, they may never get to see the purpose of their life. They lay on their deathbed wondering if their life mattered. But I think every life matters. But sometimes we don't see the purpose until long after we're gone. My advice, go live your life. Go live an exceptional life. Engage in life. And life will find its purpose in you if you keep living. And that's my two cents.